out there. He's a very influential player for Manchester City. And he's made changes. Yaya Toure has been very inconsistent for me this year. You know, at times he looks a world beater. Other times he looks like he's, you know, his brother's playing. So he's a situation, not Colo.
So I've arrived at Sandal BMW Wakefield and got Mini over there. So we're just going to take a look inside both showrooms. We've got this lovely BMW M6 Grand Coupe here in San Marino blue, an exclusive colour choice. Looks gorgeous. Got the cream leather inside as well. Just sat in an M4 customers. They saw us photographing and filming, so they let us sit inside. Legend. Yeah, really nice spec on this. And then there's a Silverstone blue M4 coupe there. We're just going to head on in and have a look inside. So just inside Sandal BMW Wakefield, we've got a couple of nice M cars. We've got this Yas Marina blue M4 cabriolet, which was it was here last time actually. Black leather interior, very smart. But a new addition, which we're here to see, is this yellow M4 coupe with the M Performance kit. It's got the M Performance splitter and the carbon front pods. Looks really good. This is speed yellow individual, which is actually a Porsche colour. I've actually seen this on an E92 M3 as well, which looks the business. Interior, yeah, carbon package. Come back to interior in a minute. Looks awesome. And then, I'm just doing a video. The Ferrari red F80 M3 saloon. Again with the carbon pack, carbon mirrors. It's the facelift, yeah. Carbon wing. Love the facelift tail lights. And then, yeah, behind it, got the X6M. This is a beast. Very nice. So I'm now just sat inside the speed yellow M4 coupe. Really nice colour choice for this car. It just does it so much justice. But yeah, just sat inside it now. It's got the carbon fibre. This one doesn't have the extended leather pack, which the Ferrari red F80 M3 does. Yeah, DCT, which pretty much all the M3 and M4s are. And yeah, oh, is that a M5? I think that was an F10 M5 that just drove past. But yeah. Just sat now inside the Ferrari red F80 M3. This one's got the extended leather pack. It's got the leather here on the dash and the door cards, which is really nice. I'd have the extended leather if I were to have one. Just makes it a bit nicer inside. Carbon centre console.
It's carbon centre console. Yeah. This could actually have the extended leather pack because these seats are very nice and padded and supportive, and also
yeah, they are good seats.
They are good seats, really nice seats. Could never tell they were sports seats, but I definitely do think it does have. Right, guys. Yeah, I think it definitely does have the extended leather pack because...
Yeah, it does, because it's when it's the leather, soft leather on the dash and all
soft
that.
Leather on the dash.
Because the Speed Yellow M4 doesn't have it.
No, definitely the M4 doesn't have it, so... Go on.
But, yeah.
Back to you, Jordan.
Yeah, anyway, that's about it.
That's about it on this F80 M3 coupe.
So we're just sat now inside the X6M. Awesome car.
Awesome V8.
Yeah, V8. Well, basically, it's the same engine as the F10 M5 and the M6.
Gas.
About, 575 brake. Just going to look through the media system now.
So, let's just, obviously I'm controlling this.
Yeah.
We'll just have a quick look at this multimedia system. So, you can have CD, DVD, music collection, external devices. That's what, if we just have a quick look down here. Don't think I can open these, but there's a...
Just press that.
Yeah. And the other one.
You can see there.
You can just see there.
Auxiliary and
a USB, so
connection.
That's what
hooks
up.
It's got this snapping phone adapter. If you press that, it lifts up, which is pretty nifty. And just clips back in like that.
And so the USB will obviously be for the external devices and sound. You've obviously got your... Because it's a upgraded sound system, it's the Cardon.
Harman Kardon.
Upgraded sound system, you get your treble, bass, balance, fader, equalizer, and Logic 7 surround.
Yeah.
So we will go on the switches to the radio. It's full DAB, as you'd expect, with a £100,000 car.
Yeah. Got everything you need.
Navigation. We just have it zoom out. You can obviously see your full sort of where you are in the world.
Yeah.
So if we zoom right down to where we are.
Wakefield.
BMW, it highlights it.
Oh, yeah.
And if you obviously scroll out, we can see there's a petrol station, which there is.
There is.
And there's plenty of petrol stations about. And talking to petrol stations, you probably
You're going to spend a lot of time in a petrol station.
With a car, you said.
Yeah, we'll leave it at that. That's the X6M interior.
Very difficult. If that's even a word, you have to sit down, literally sitting down.
Oh yeah, that's the way of doing it.
And then you're in.
Yeah.
See you later.
So you're just sat inside the i8 now. We've just shown you how to get inside an i8. Not very,
very difficult.
Yeah, it's difficult. Even like after sitting in like Aventadors and McLarens and stuff, it's just a door so high up. But really nice. It's my first i8 to sit in, actually. Gorgeous car. Probably the last car that we're going to sit in at BMW. We've just sat in the i8 and now sat in this 640D cab, which is very nice. Again, this one's got the extended leather pack. Very nice interior. We've got the cigarette lighter down here, which is
nice
pretty
touch.
Cool. Yeah. And then, like the X6M, it's got the snapping adapter and
USB and aux down here as well.
USB and auxiliary.
I think that's a 12 volt maybe. No, it is. Yes?
Yeah, 12 volt.
Yeah.
But yeah. Beautiful car.
Plenty of charging purposes there.
Yeah.